population of Indonesia in 2010 is about 237.6 million people, and 13.33% of them are poor people. From the total number of these poor people, 46.23% of them live in the rural areas. There are various government programs that has been done to alleviate poverty, like investasi tertinggal, bantuan langsung tunai, PMPN mandiri, and some other programs. However, some of them are not well targeted. This is caused by the poor planning process that does not see the real condition of the poor people. Some program has a very complicated procedure that is ineffective and inefficient. The effort to alleviate poverty shows some paradigmatic fallacies. For example, they are more oriented to the economic aspect than the multidimensional aspect. They are more generous-oriented than productive-oriented. They place the poor people as object, not subject, and the government still function as a rural rather than a facilitator. One of the government efforts to reduce poverty in order to improve the welfare of Indonesian population is rural-based development. Agriculture is a complex and interrelated sector. So, in the future, we need a concept of integrated and sustainable agriculture development that can be used as an alternative solution in reducing poverty in Indonesia. However, the government needs to create a new policy that supports multi-sector, integrated, and sustainable agriculture. Healthy lifestyle has been institutionalized internationally, which requires the assurance that agricultural products like safe to eat, nutritious, and eco-friendly. This is why the world of organic farming is increasing rapidly. The purpose of writing this paper are to explain about the natural and agro-climate potential of Indonesia, which can be used to develop integrated and sustainable organic agriculture as an alternative solution in reducing poverty of Indonesia, especially in the rural area. And then to explain about the concept and the implementation step of integrated and sustainable organically farming based movement or INSOFARM to reduce poverty in Indonesia, especially in the rural area, and to explain about the implication of INSOFARM in developing productive business, which is able to create more job vacancies. To answer the objective of this paper, the writer uses a descriptive comparative analysis by studying some relevant literatures got from a variety of sources. The findings show that organic farming in Indonesia has not been developed with integrated and sustainable system. Recently, modern organic farming of Indonesia's agriculture system was developed sporadically and narrowly. One alternative to address this problem is INSOFARM. INSOFARM is an innovation program directed purpose that aims to mobilize a village to become self-sufficient village in organic agriculture. In the implementations, village will be divided into three cluster: on-farm cluster, animal husbandry cluster, and off-farm cluster. On-farm cluster will produce organic farming waste, which can be used to feed the animals in the animal husbandry cluster. The animal husbandry cluster will produce animal waste, which can be used as a biofertilizer of organic farming. Product of both on-farm and animal husbandry cluster will be further processed to be higher economical value product. Thus can optimize the function of village units cooperations of that village in marketing the product. In addition, there are some stakeholders like government, academia, businessmen, bank, and the others in implementation of INSOFARM. Synergy and commitment of all stakeholders are needed to optimize the implementation of INSOFARM. There are four steps of ways to implement INSOFARM. The first is creating pilot village, and then evaluations, promotion and publications, and nationally implementations. The advantage of this program is to integrate organic farming and livestock sustainably, both on-farm and off-farm farming, by involving local human resources, especially the youths in the rural areas. It is believed that this program will form a strong and competitive rural farming and support the government programs to reduce poverty by improving the competency of rural communities. In addition, tough, competitive, and smart young generation will surely be produced, and they will have an interest and good effort to develop an integrated and sustainable organic farming. To support the sustainability of the program, it is necessary to conduct a more thorough study on the characteristic of the villagers so that the application of INSO form will be optimal. Support and awareness of the government, rural people, academia, and other stakeholders are importantly needed in order to keep the natural conservation for the successful implementation of INSO Farm.